Hello everyone. Welcome to my YouTube channel. I have started this channel to share my knowledge on pharmacovigilance with you all. So let's get start. When you think about pharmacovigilance, first question may arise. What is pharmacovigilance? Because for many of you this is a new concept. So we will look at the definition first. Pharmacovigilance is defined as science and activities related to detection, assessment, understanding, and prevention of any kind of adverse reactions associated due to the use of any drug. To understand this definition, we need to understand what is benefit and risk ratio of drug. All drugs along with potential beneficial effect have some side effect as well. However, effect of the drug is more than its side effects. This is called benefit and risk ratio. So now come back to first step in pharmacovigilance, which is detection. In this step, we detect any new signal of drug. New signal means any new safety information about drug use, which affect the benefit to risk ratio associated with the use of a drug. In simple language, we can say, now benefit of drug is less than its risk. To understand this, we will take an example of drug, nimesulide. It's a medication used to treat acute pain like headache and fever. However, it has severe side effect like liver damage in a long run. So here we detect the signal of nimesulide as liver damage. Now next step is assessment. In this step we assess the severity of the detected signal. For example, in our previous example of nimesulide causing liver damage, we need to assess whether liver damage is serious issue arises due to use of nimesulide. For better assessment of signal, we need to collect sufficient data on the signal. Next step is understanding. In this step we perform detailed understanding of the detected signal based on various parameters like severity of the signal, benefit and risk ratio of the signal, etc. Again, we will take example of nimesulide causing liver damage to understand this.
We identified that
majority of people needed liver transplant after long-term use of nimesulide, or majority of people had died after long-term use of nimesulide. Here we can conclude that the benefit out of nimesulide is less than its side effect. Last step is prevention. To understand this, we directly jump to the example.
Based on all the parameters, drug nimesulide found unsafe to use and was banned from the market, considering patient safety.
So this is what exactly pharmacovigilance is. I hope you like this video. If you found this information helpful, please subscribe to this channel, like the video, and press bell icon to never miss next video. You can provide your valuable inputs in comment section. Don't forget to check the description for more information. Thanks for watching. See you soon in next video.